Hello, welcome to My Dreams Academy. Today we are going to see a beautiful concept that is generation. In this generation, we are going to see hydroelectric power plant, next one thermal power plant, next one nuclear, next one gas power plant, next one solar power plant. Okay, hydroelectric power plant, thermal power plant, nuclear power plant, gas power plant, solar power plant. In this, solar is a renewable energy sources, remaining these all are non-renewable energy sources. First we'll going to see hydroelectric power station, then after thermal, then after nuclear, then after gas power plant, then after solar. The first one is hydroelectric power plant. First one, hydroelectric power plant, or another name of hydroelectric power plant is Heidel plant. Heidel plant. Now the name itself, hydro, meaning of hydro is water. By using water we are generating electrical output power. By using water we are generating electrical output power. Okay, now in this, the first topic is principle of generation. We are going to see on what basis hydroelectric power plant is working, that we are going to see. The principle is, we have a water, then after we have a turbine, then after we have a generator. Okay, water, turbine, generator. In this the concept of water is, we have to store the water. That storing water is nothing but potential energy. That storing water is nothing but potential energy. Okay, if we release that water, it will get kinetic energy. If release water, that will get kinetic energy. When water hits the turbine, the kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy. The kinetic energy can be converted into mechanical energy. Now generator. The generator converts mechanical energy to the electrical output. Okay, electrical output or electrical energy. See, according to the energy conservation principle, energy not destroyed nor created, it can be converted one form to other form. So according to energy conservation principle, the stored water energy, that is potential energy, is converted into kinetic energy. We are stored in the dams. Okay, when we release the water from the dams, the water hits the turbine. So kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy. The turbine rotates, that is called mechanical energy. Okay, that rotation will rotate the prime mover. the prime mover will convert mechanical energy to the electrical energy. This is the principle of operation of a hydroelectric power plant. Next one, we'll going to see power equation. First one is principle of operation, next one is power equation. Power equation in hydroelectric power plant. This is very important. Okay. We have a water. Let us take 75 kg of water. 75 kg of water. And it has some speed, that is meter per second. 75 kg of water in 1 second time, if it is travels to 1 meter, it will generate 1 HP power, that is metric horsepower, which is equals to 735 watts. Now if we wanted to transmit 1 kg of water in 1 second of the distance 1 meter, then it will give 735 divided by this 75, it will give 9.81. Now the power equation P is equals to 9.81 into W H Q into zeta. This is the power equation. This 9.81 into 9.81 is nothing but 735 by 75, that is equals to 9.81, where W is discharge of water, that is kg per meter cube, where H is head of the water, that is nothing but water level, where H is head of the water. Head of the water in meters. Next one is Q. Q is discharge. What is the units of discharge? That is meter cube per second. And zeta. Zeta is efficiency in per unit. The power equation P is equals to 9.81 W H Q zeta. The units of W is kg per meter cube. H, head of the water in meter. Next Q, meter cube per second. This is the discharge of water. And zeta, that is efficiency in per unit. And similarly, this can be calculated in different forms. Okay. Now, if we wanted to write this in terms of kilowatts, here it is watts. If you wanted to write this in terms of kilowatts, how I can write? That is P is equals to 735 divided by 75 into 1000. Now this is in terms of kilowatts. That is, I can write 9.81 divided by 1000 W H Q zeta kilowatts. W H Q zeta kilowatts. Now next one, Next one. In this total earth, let us consider this is total earth, we have a 70% of water and remaining 30% is land. This water is from rains and also in the form of ice in the Everest. Okay, this is from rains plus in the form of I can say ice or etc. Okay, this total water we called as a precipitation. The total water we called as a precipitation. Now, because of some water will again evaporates. That is called evaporation. Now, the runoff will be calculated like this. That is total water available. That is precipitation minus evaporation. This is the total water available in this. Now, in Telangana, we have mainly three types of hydroelectric power stations. One is Nagarjuna Sagar. Another one is Srishalam. Next one is Sriram Sagar project. The capacity of Sriram Sagar project is 90 kilowatts. The capacity of Sriram Sagar is 90 kilowatts. And the capacity of Nagarjuna Sagar power plant is 312 kilowatts. And the capacity of Srishalam power plant is 215 kilowatts. So total we have mainly three types. One is Nagarjuna Sagar power plant. The total capacity is 312 kilowatts. Srishalam power plant having 215 kilowatts. Sriram Sagar power plant contains 90 kilowatts. Now, the next concept is flow graph. Before going to flow graph, the stored water is measured in terms of TMC. TMC is nothing but 1000 million cubic second. Okay, 1000 million cubic second. 1000 million cubic. Next, we'll going to see flow graph. We're going to see what is flow graph and why we need to draw. The flow graph is drawn between time to discharge. Okay, discharge and time. Time in seconds, that is meter cube per second. The graph will be drawn like this. Okay, why we need to draw this one flow graph? This is the graph between discharge and time. And why we need to draw? By using this, we can able to calculate high discharge at a particular time. And also we can able to find low discharge at what time. High discharge, maximum discharge we can able to calculate. Minimum discharge also we can able to calculate. Similarly, we can able to calculate average discharge, maximum discharge, minimum discharge. We can able to calculate. And the area under this curve will give total volume total volume of water. Total volume of water. So the information of this will give installed capacity. Installed capacity of hydro electric power plant. ఓకే మనం ఫ్లో గ్రాఫ్ నుండి ఏమేమి నేర్చుకోవచ్చు మ్యాక్సిమమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ డిశ్చార్జ్ వి కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు ఫైండ్ మినిమమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ డిశ్చార్జ్ దట్ వీ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు ఫైండ్ యావరేజ్ డిశ్చార్జ్ వీ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు ఫైండ్ అండ్ ద ఏరియా ఆఫ్ దిస్ వన్ ఏరియా ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ డిశ్చార్జ్ ఇన్ టు టైమ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిశ్చార్జ్ యూనిట్స్ దట్ ఈస్ మీటర్ క్యూబ్ పర్ సెకండ్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ వన్ ఈజ్ సెకండ్ 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 గెట్ క్యాన్సల్ ఇట్ విల్ గివ్ ఎం cube, that is nothing but meter cube. What is it means? Meter cube is nothing but volume of the water. Volume of the water, we can able to calculate volume of the water. From this we can able to calculate installed capacity of hydroelectric power plant. Just now only we have seen Nagarjuna power plant has some set some capacity, installed capacity. What is that one? 312 megawatts. This is because of by using flow graph. Okay, and another name of flow graph is hydrograph. Hydrograph. Okay, this is the information about flow graph and hydrograph. What is the main important thing from by using flow graph or hydrograph? That is, we can able to calculate installed capacity of hydroelectric power plant. Next one is, this is okay. Now how to see which land is suitable, the selection of land, that is nothing but selection of hydroelectric power plant, that is nothing but we have to select the site. We have to select the site. Okay, let us consider one area. This area should be near to the transportation. It has a good transportation. And this is hydroelectric power plant. So water should be, high amount of water should be available. And what is the next one? If you transmit to the longer distance, if you transmit electric power to the longer distance, there will be a huge losses. So this electric power plant should be near to the load centers. It should be near to load centers. These all are requirement to select the site of a hydroelectric power plant. But see, this is very difficult. Loads near to the load centers. Okay, we can generate hydroelectric power plant only at when we have a water. Okay, only at when we have water. If you wanted to construct hydroelectric plant near to the load center, is it not possible? Because everywhere water is not available, so it is not possible to construct hydroelectric power plants at near to the load centers. So this is one of the disadvantages. Now we are going to see classification of hydroelectric power plant. Classification of hydroelectric
plant. That is by using based on the installed capacity.
Before going to this, mainly the hydroelectric power plants are three types. One is by using runoff river. That is nothing but river lo flow a water nundi, a water flow ni turbine ki connect cheyadam. That is called runoff river type. And another one is runoff river with pondage. That is nothing but if we have some storage, that is not nothing but runoff river type with pondage. Next one is reservoir. Most of the hydroelectric power plants are this reservoir type, because we have to install a synchronous generator. For that, always it should have a continuous flow of water with some constant speed. That is called synchronous speed. Okay, generally we use synchronous generators, so it required constant speed. So because of that, we generally use reservoir type. By using runoff river type and runoff river type with pondage, it cannot be able to give a constant speed. Now, based on installed capacity, classification of hydroelectric power plant based on installed capacity. One is mini hydroelectric power plant. What is the range of mini hydroelectric power plant? That is 5 to 10 megawatts. And the next one is medium hydroelectric power plant. What is the range of medium? That is 10 megawatt to 100 megawatts. Next one is large hydroelectric power plant. That is 100 megawatts to 1000 megawatts. Next one is ultra large hydroelectric power plant. This is greater than 1000 megawatts. Okay, we are classifying the hydroelectric power plant by using installed capacity. If it is, the installed capacity is between 5 to 10 megawatts, that is called mini hydroelectric power plant. if the generation is between 10 megawatts to 100 megawatts, that is medium hydroelectric power plant. Like in Telangana, Sri Ram Sagar project. Sri Ram Sagar hydroelectric power plant comes under medium hydroelectric power plant, and large hydroelectric power plant, that is Srishalam and Nagarjuna Sagar. These two power plants comes under large hydroelectric power plants. Ultra large hydroelectric power plants. Now in India, now we are constructing this type of hydroelectric power plants. Very few hydroelectric power plants is from this.